Welcome to the expression of the Father's love. I'm happy that you are here today to listen to the Word of God. And I trust today, as you listen to the Word of God and through the Holy Spirit, the mighty God will minister to your heart and to your life. So stay tuned as we look into the Word of God today. If you have your Bibles available, you can turn with me to the book of John, St. John chapter 3, from verse 1 to 21. St. John chapter 3, from verse 1 to 21. It reads, "There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. For no man can do these miracles that thou doest, except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Nicodemus said unto him, How can a man be born when he's old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. That which is born of flesh is flesh, and that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. Marvel not that I said unto thee, he must be born again. The wind bloweth where it listeth, and thou hearest the sound thereof, but thou canst tell from whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus answered and said unto him, How can these things be? Jesus answered and said unto him, Art thou a master of Israel, and knowest not these things? Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak that we do know, and testify that we have seen, and ye receive not our witness. If I told you earthly things, and ye believe not, how shall ye believe if I tell you of heavenly things? And no man hath ascended to heaven, but he that came down from heaven, even the Son of Man, which is in heaven. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is come into the world, and men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds were evil. For everyone that doeth evil hateth the light, neither cometh to the light, lest his deeds should be reproved. But he that doeth truth cometh to the light, that his deeds may be made manifest, that they are wrought in God." Father, we thank you for your word today. Bless it to our hearts, in Jesus' name. Today I'm going to speak to us on a simple subject. Ye must be born again. Notice very clearly the imperative.
The Bible tells us, as Jesus responded to this Pharisee named Nicodemus, in simply saying to him, you must be born again. This is imperative. This was a discussion that Jesus shared with Nicodemus. The Bible tells us this was not an ordinary man. He was a Pharisee, a teacher of the Jews, a Jewish rabbi, a Jewish leader. And he came to Jesus because he was convinced, like others in his circle, in the height of Jesus' ministry, that he was in fact a great man of God. In fact, they claimed he probably is the Son of God in truth. Probably he is the Messiah, the King of the Jews. We are not sure. Whatever the concern of Nicodemus was, one thing is certain, that he didn't wait for somebody to tell him. The Bible tells us that he went to seek Jesus. And he went at night. The circumstances why he would have gone at night is not declared to us. But one thing is certain. He went to Jesus himself. He wants to find out for himself about the eternal kingdom. He wants to experience God. He wants to ensure that this man, hallelujah, who in fact to them is in fact the Messiah, he will tell us all things. The Bible says as he came to Jesus by night, Jesus wastes no time. He went straight to the point because man have a need. His need is eternal life. Whether he believes it or not, this is his great need. So Jesus wastes no time. And he comes straight to the point as though he's hitting the bullseye, saying to Nicodemus, a religious man, a teacher of the Jews, saying to him, you must be born again. If Christ says that to Nicodemus, a teacher of the Jews, if Christ says that to a religious man, a leader of the people, a teacher of the people, one thing is certain, Christ wants to ensure that every man, from the highest to the lowest, must understand one important fact. If you're going to see the kingdom of God, if you're going to experience everlasting life, you must be born again. People need to know that today. It is no option. You have very little option. In fact, this is the case. If you're going to see the kingdom of God, if you're going to experience everlasting life with the Messiah, with the King of Kings, you must be born again. This is a message for every man and for every boy. This is a message for the great and for the small. This is the message for the rich and for the poor. This is a message for all men. If you're going to experience the kingdom of God, sir, you must. Not the imperative. You must be born again. You may ask the question, how can a man be born again? Well, Jesus explained that to Nicodemus in the very text. Let us look at some of the things that Jesus explained to Nicodemus on how one must be born again. Firstly, the Bible tells us, hallelujah, in verse 5, Jesus says to Nicodemus, according to verse 5, truly, truly, or rather, verily, verily, this is no lie. This is the truth I'm going to say to you. I say, Jesus is saying, take note of what Jesus is saying. How you're going to be born again? Not my idea. Not some great man idea. This is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords saying to all humanity how you're going to be born again. So it's important that we take note. What he says, I say unto you, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God except a man be born of water and of the Spirit. You cannot enter the kingdom of God. Right away we're seeing where God is approving, hallelujah, the baptism of John. Right away we are seeing where God and the Son of God is approving water baptism, signifying your alliance with the Savior, signifying that you are, hallelujah, being linked to what Jesus has approved. The baptism, hallelujah, just as Christ died and rose again, when one is water baptized, hallelujah, he is signifying, just as Jesus was dead and was buried and rose again, I am putting to death the old man, that Adamic man, that man that was rebellious against God. I'm putting him to death. I'm putting him, hallelujah, down. And just as, hallelujah, Christ rose again and never to die again, hallelujah, so as I rose from the water, hallelujah, I'm signifying that I'm a new man in Christ Jesus. Yes, before I was baptized, I was wretched, I was wicked, I was evil. But this is a physical manifestation of what I've already transformed on the inside of me. Yes, I raise again to walk in newness of life. This water baptism is a signal to the world, hallelujah, that I'm a newborn man. It's a signal to the world that I'm changed. So the places I used to go, I should not go there no more. The things I used to do, I must not do them no more. It must signify to the world a great change in my life. And Jesus saw that as important because we need to carry a message to the world today. People who are born again, people who are water baptized, it's important that we walk right, speak right, live right, because it's a testimony that I'm changed. I have chosen to walk with him. I have chosen to follow this Jesus. And what I have done by being baptized in water is signifying, in fact, to the world that I'm changed. And I'm not ashamed to be aligned with the King of Kings. I'm not ashamed to align with the Lord of Lords. Many people who are baptized, hallelujah, is changing off. They are not living consistent with the word of God. Hallelujah, what have happened on the inside, hallelujah, is not reflecting on the inside, outside, because some people are afraid. Some people are ashamed to be aligned with the King of Kings. Hallelujah, they are ashamed of Christ. They don't want people to know that they are saved, that they are changed, that they are different. My God, if ever a time we need to let people know that we are changed, it's now. We are living in a sick world. We are living in a world that is riddled with evil, and the system of the world, hallelujah, have led men to become covetous after things that are temporal. But I'm here to tell you today, Jesus make this abundant declare that you got to be born again of water. You got to align yourself with him. You got to tell the world that I'm changed and I'm walking with Jesus. Because that's what baptism must signify. Hallelujah, that I'm aligned with Jesus. And Jesus went further. Hallelujah, not only must you demonstrate that, hallelujah, but indeed in spirit and in truth, you must be born again. You must be born of the Spirit. The Spirit conversion is in fact a sincere conversion of the heart, where we are led
by him, where we are led by the Spirit of God, where we are in fact the sons of God, not because of what is written to the place we go to worship, but what has happened on the inside of us. We are changed on the inside. The Spirit now leads us and we follow. He's calling for a conversion. He's calling for an inner conversion that is reflected on the outside. He is calling for a submission to the Spirit of Almighty God. He's calling, hallelujah, for one who are led by his Spirit. For they that are led by his Spirit are in fact the sons of God. So Jesus made it abundantly clear, hallelujah, in order for you to experience the kingdom of God, in order for you to be truly born again, you must be born of water and you must be born of the Spirit. Hallelujah. In fact, hallelujah, Nicodemus seemed not to be understanding this concept, and Jesus went on further to explain it. He says, marvel not that I said unto thee, he must be born again. Hallelujah. In verse 8 he says, the wind bloweth where it listeth, and we heareth the song thereof, but cannot tell whence it cometh and whither it goeth. So is everyone that is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus becoming even more confused. Nicodemus says in verse 9, hallelujah, how can these things be? How can these things be? And Jesus, secondly, Jesus is going a little deeper to share what is involved in the Spirit being born again. In verse 10, Jesus says, thou art the master of Israel, and knowest not these things. Verily, verily, I say unto thee, we speak what we do know, and testify what we have seen, and he received not our witness. If I told you earthly things, and he believed not, how shall he believe if I tell you of heavenly things? In verse 14, Jesus began to explain to him how this Spirit birth will take place. In verse, hallelujah, 14, he says, and as Moses was lifted up in the wilderness, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. Jesus is clearly telling him, hallelujah, that the Son of Man will be lifted up in the crucifixion, just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, that anyone who was bitten, just look by faith upon the brazen serpent on the pole, they will be made whole. Just look to him. What was hidden in the Old Testament is now being revealed. Jesus Christ is explaining what Moses did, hallelujah, by lifting up the brazen serpent on the pole in the wilderness, that all who was bitten by the fiery serpent, because of their complaining, because of their grievances, when they look, they will be made whole. Jesus Christ in the New Testament is telling Nicodemus, anybody who look to the Son of Man in faith, those who look to him, hallelujah, in an expectancy to follow him, those who would want to align with him, those who want to be a part of his household, they are and they will be saved. So Jesus is saying, hallelujah, just as the serpent was lifted up, this Son of Man will be lifted up, and those who come to him, those who believe in him, those who trust in him, will have everlasting life, and they will see the kingdom of God. And he begin to explain it further. Jesus is emphasizing the whole aspect of belief. He's emphasizing the Spirit birth require belief. It require faith. It require trusting in God. So he begins to explain it in verse 15. He says, whoever... This becomes an individual thing. Hallelujah. You want to be born again? Jesus says, whoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You're going to possess the everlasting life if you believe in him, if you trust in Jesus. This is the spirit conversion now. It calls for inner belief. It calls for you in your heart, trusting in Jesus alone to ensure eternal life. Why that is important? Because we're living in a time where anybody believe, and some people believe there are several ways to God. Some believe they can go any religion, serve any God. Once they're praying daily, they're on their way. They are born again. No, sir. This is very clear. Jesus is saying that whoever believeth in him, who is that him? Who is that him? The one who was lifted up. The one who will be lifted up for your sins. The one who die for your sins. His name is Jesus, the Son of the living God. And whoever believeth in him will not perish. It is very clear. It's very clear. And Jesus begin to take it a notch higher. Jesus begin to tell us, you're not going to believe. Just like that, the Bible tells us in verse 16, for God, this is God's initiative now, sending his only begotten Son. Who? Sending Jesus. That whoever believeth in him, whoever trusts in him, whoever commit his entire life in his hands, forsaking the world and following Jesus, Jesus gives us a guarantee that we will not perish, but we'll have everlasting life. Jesus Christ is taking the belief to a deep level. He's saying that this is not for individual thing. I know you Jews think that, hallelujah, salvation is of the Jews. But this, hallelujah, is going to spread to all humanity. Jesus Christ is in love, and he's going to die for the world in order to give them everlasting life. Because if they are not born again, if they are not born again, they cannot enter the kingdom of God. This is the crux of the matter. Jesus wants every man to experience the kingdom of God. But in order for you to experience the kingdom of God, you must. This is the criteria. You must. It's not optional. You must be born again. And he takes in the spirit, hallelujah, into a deeper realm. In verse 17, he says, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him shall be saved. This is the hope of God, that the world through who? Him. Jesus alone. Jesus alone. This is what God, Jesus Christ, is sharing with Nicodemus. Hallelujah, there are not many ways to God. There are but one way. One way. Jesus Christ is the way. The only way. So if you think that you're going to make it into the kingdom of God by any other route, sir, you have been winked. You have been bewitched. You have been fooled. This is a testimony of Jesus himself. He's saying to Nicodemus, I say unto you and to all of us, you gotta be born again. And being born again requires being born of water, being associated and aligned, and a physical manifestation that I'm following Jesus by demonstrating to the world that I'm changed. And secondly, it speaks about a spirit conversion where it requires trusting in God through Jesus Christ, trusting in Jesus with all our hearts and all our soul. Because God did not send his only begotten Son into the world to condemn you, sir. No, he didn't send you to point out and show you the way of damnation. No, but he's showing you the way to his eternal kingdom. And that way, hallelujah, you got to acknowledge Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior. You got to be water baptized. Hallelujah. I'm saying to you, even if you're not water baptized, but on the brink of death, hallelujah, you want to be born again. It's possible. But while you're alive and have health and strength, it's important that that you demonstrate to the world that you are different through water baptism. Through water baptism, that when you are dead in Christ, hallelujah, when you are dead, hallelujah, and rise again, symbolically, as how Jesus died and rose again, symbolically, when you are baptized, you are buried with him in water baptism, and that you are raised again in eternal life to live for him for the rest of your life. It's a symbol to the world. And the spirit baptism requires believing in Jesus Christ, trusting in Jesus Christ with all your heart and with all your soul. The Bible says, he that believeth on him is not condemned. Verse 18. But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he had not believed in the only. Note that word. You are condemned because you believe not in the only begotten Son of God. And this is the condemnation, that light is coming to the world and men love darkness rather than light because their deeds are evil. God wants to save you, young man. Right where you are, just bow your head. I've been calling you a long time and you have been resisting him, but today is your day. Just say after me, dear Lord, I am a sinner. Forgive me of my sins. I believe that Jesus Christ died for my sins, was buried, and on the third day he rose again from the dead for my justification. I believe that, and I will live the rest of my life for him. So help me, O God. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you have prayed that prayer, you are saved right now. Find a good Bible-believing church and attend it regularly. I want you to pray every day. Ask God to help you. I want you to tell somebody of the decision you have made today, because that is important, right? And I want you to go to church regularly. Find a good Bible-believing church in your area and go there. And finally, ensure that you follow Jesus all the way, being baptized, being born of the water and of the Spirit, and prepare for the heavenly kingdom, because Jesus Christ will certainly come again for his own. The Lord richly bless you, and thank you for tuning in to the expression of the Father's love. The Lord bless you. Until next time, shalom.
This program comes to you compliments of the Tobago Inspirational Network. To support this and other programs, we encourage you to give to TIN. Contributions can be made at any First Citizens Bank at account number 203-4679. We thank you for your support.